Cracker the Naturopath from New Zealand. We're back on the vitamin C topic. Thanks for coming back. I always appreciate people looking at the videos. Well, questions. We've got sheets of questions from people regarding the vitamin C. Does vitamin C help to fight bacterial infections? Well, it does, in fact. In fact, I just had a look at a very interesting study, which is a compilation of 148 different animal studies regarding vitamin C that showed overwhelming evidence that vitamin C has an effect on lab animals, and we've got no doubt to believe the same holds true for humans, because humans also show the same effects. We're talking bacterial infections, viral infections, protozoan infections, many different types of infections are positively affected with vitamin C. But there's been a huge bias against vitamin C now for so long. I just also read a study that almost half the doctors in countries like Germany and Holland still believe that homeopathy in fact can cure the common cold, whereas less than 20% believe that for vitamin C. Remember, there's a huge amount of propaganda when it comes to pharmaceutical interests, you know, particularly when it comes to cancer, pushing interferon, fluorouracil and drugs like that onto people. But intravenous vitamin C is shown to be superior for many diseases, chronic diseases, you know, that people using pharmaceutical medications for. But yes, it's kicked to the curb as if it's just rubbish. I think a long time people didn't really believe that vitamin C had much effect on the immune system, because after all, it cured scurvy, which is a connective tissue disorder, you know, loose gums, loose teeth and bleeding gums and things like that, painful joints. So the medical fraternity never really believed it had much effect on the immune system. We know now that's completely untrue. It has a seriously good effect on the immune system. Now, vitamin C affects both the cell-mediated response and the humoral response, so it affects large aspects of a person's immune functioning. It has a big effect on neutrophil activity, so it increases how neutrophils, or first-line defense white cells, gobble up bacteria. But it also has effect on the other part of the immune system, the back end or the humoral response. So it allows better communication of those cells and increased production of anti-inflammatory mediators. You still with me? What I'm trying to say in English is it flipping well works. It works on bacteria. It works on viruses. It works on many different things. Give it a go. It's called vitamin C. Thanks for tuning in.